So this is 480i. Switches to 240p. The 480i mode from the Linux bot transcoder is really sharp, so you still see like some sort of scan lines, but it flickers. This does not. I'm gonna have some coffee and we'll jump into it. The controls are very responsive on this display. I'm flinging this joystick. I've never played a real Saturn, but it feels, yeah, like very little added lag, if there is. Yeah, the ground flashing in this stage, in the next one, is a bug in Menafin. I'm using Beetle Saturn and RetroArch, but I mean that bug's been happening all this year, as long as I've been using it. And I've been updating it. I don't think it's been updated in a hot while. These run at, I don't know, the speed of 60 frames per second, but I don't know if they're really 60 frames. Looks kind of sped up, but... Thank you. Moray, I'm going to adjust it. There still might be Moray. I paused and adjusted it, but it's still kind of there. This time I'm using my 8-bit Doe SN30, so you don't hear me spamming the button so much. So my Saturn controller, it's kind of loud. Yeah, game emulates great. Very little issues. Sega Saturn emulation is pretty good. That's me. I'm pretty happy with it. Wasn't sure what the button was to pull that off on this pad. Hopefully we're not in for it. I was playing this game a lot earlier this year, but I haven't played it recently. Man, not much going on, but it looks nice. Hopefully we don't die here. I can normally wipe this boss out without getting hit, so we shouldn't. That was too close. I could not waste that bomb. It's just for the thumbnail. Yeah, it doesn't look like he levels up in toy box mode. Not toy box, Pandora's box. So we'll see how far we get before we cannot beat it anymore. Let me grab my stick vape here. I don't know if I didn't hit my tripod too bad, or... If you hate this song, write a comment. I don't know. That's my attempt at YouTubing. Let's find them haters. Where the haters at? Panzer Dragoon haters. Definitely save their state because I'm not accurate. Thank you. I'm not gonna make it. I got too lazy. I got too whatever complacent about my save state. I'm still gonna try to beat it. I've done it before, so definitely have it. I'm not lying. No, I actually. Oh no. Alright, I'm done. This is fun to do. So much fun. Tracing your enemies. It's the name of the game. Is this hurting?
Yep.
Definitely abuse his shot more. Be really hard for me, but now when you know what he's going to do, it really isn't bad. It's always the second group of bullets that get you. Unless you aim up here. Trees. Oh. No. I'm really bad at this stage, so let's see how many times it takes to beat it. So I've been trying to do this video for a little while, but this stage always trips me up. If you run head-to-head, head on with them. It does a lot of damage. A lot more than the shots do. Fireman. It's better off just missing out on entirely. That was in safe states. It makes us, yeah, if I had a real Saturn, I don't know what I would do. I'd be screwed. Because I like safe states. I do like learning the game, but this makes it so less abrasive. It's just smoother to jump in and play. You definitely don't, if you can pull off a setup like this and all you want to do is play on a CRT, you don't need to buy a Saturn, just do this. Really. Even when Mr. comes out, that Saturn Core, you could do that too. But this will probably still be a little better just because all the other systems and all the other arcade machines you can do on a computer, like CPS3 games. You want to play some Red Earth, it's fun. JoJo's Adventure, Bizarre Adventure, great games. I like Bizarre Adventure, really. It's one I've played. I was flying blind for a second to do a save state. I just turned around and hit F2 on the keyboard. If you heard that, it's barely audible. Here is always a little tricky for me. Whenever he starts firing up those pink bullets, those red ones. Thank you. just making it for these bosses, but you know, that's the point. I'm not definitely not the best. It's just cool showing off how I play these games, I think. I want to see more people play like this, really. I mean, people love the FPGAs and stuff, but this is a great alternative if you like computers. If you don't like computers, you're probably screwed, but if you don't mind them, yeah, don't spend a weekend setting up. You'll be very happy. Yeah, and I don't know if I have my geometry correctly set here, because it has different geometry. 16x9 and 4x3 in this set, and I have to adjust it in Arcade OSD just a hair to get everything center when I play widescreen games like this. I have to do like 20, change like something from 21 to 26, that's it. But the Saturn emulator doesn't have a lot of control over cropping over scan of the final outputted image like Beetle PSX does, or Duck Station. Those have more options that let you crop this junk off the screen, the center things, tell the emulator when to start drawing the picture from this number of pixels in. Is that going well for me? It's getting old. State. Woo! I'm on crack. Woo! I always get owned so much here at the beginning of the stage. I learned you don't even attack those little guys. It doesn't even help you out. You're better off dodging them. I think if you do, it can slow him down a little bit, but you're better off just going after this guy. I love this laser beam, it really helps out. Cuts your junk. Saves you after that. Emulation of music sounds good to me. I've never played a Saturn. Some guy on Retro RGB's like podcast, or one of his writers like one time said like Saturn's sound emulation was bad. But I don't know what he's using. Maybe it is bad, I just don't hear. Maybe he's using SSF, who knows. Thank you. My first time facing him, he blocks your lasers, and I didn't know what you had to do, so he just kept blocking them. But it turns out you can destroy it. I just got out. You just shoot at it. It does break, but it doesn't look like it. And it took like 10 minutes to take him down. Poor Dragon Doggo. I don't know. I think that's it for now. It's as much as I can really do.